गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
दादू बोल दिया क्या? हाँ हाँ बोल दिया। क्या दी जा रहा
है?
The speaker is joining very soon. Meeting.
Good morning, everyone. I have joined.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning,
good morning,
sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, namaskar.
हेलो हेलो
अच्छा ठीक गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन
सर
ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ एसआईआरटी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस सर इफ यू परमिट अस वी हैव अ वेरी शॉर्ट वीडियो अबाउट आवर इंस्टीट्यूट इट्स ओनली अबाउट 3 मिनट्स इफ यू परमिट अस वी कैन हैव वी कैन प्ले दैट
श्योर यू कैन गो अहेड
ओके थैंक यू सर this was the video all about the Sage Grove, which shows that how we at Sage are building future, that is from school to college, college to university, and from university to reality. Once again, I welcome the BL Gupta sir from NITTR Bhopal. If we should have a brief introduction. If we take about his brief introduction, if we see his qualification, then he is B in civil engineering. He has done LLB, Masters of Technical Education. He is PhD also in technical education. He has done MBA in human resource management, PG diploma in marketing, PG diploma in operational management. And in spite of all these things, he has a huge experience of 34 years in teaching, training, research, consultancy, extension, and institutional development. And he has also coordinated and contributed in more than 600 training programs for different client groups. He has also coordinated and conducted more than 70 training programs and workshop on NBA accreditation, contributed in developing information communication technology, and developed print and non-print institutional resources. He has conducted and guided more than 20 research studies in the field of management, training, and rural development. Also, he has authored 22 reference books for professional research scholars and postgraduate students. He has published more than 65 papers in national and international conferences, and currently involved in conducting various management development programs in the India. We welcome you, sir. And in the today's session, sir will enlighten us on the national education policy. Over to you, sir.
Okay, good morning, namaskar. At the outset, I would like to thank the management and the principal, sir, for inviting me to have interaction with the students and teachers. It's my privilege to be associated with SIRT. Earlier also, I had been to some functions and academic programs. I know many familiar faces, means there are many, I can see many familiar faces in the video. And my guru, Professor Mani, was there during initial period of development of SIRT. So with this opening remark, I welcome you all. Although the time is very short, but I will try to give you the very brief overview of NEP from faculty members' point of view and from students' point of view. As we all are aware through social media that NEP, National Education Policy 2020, is the first education policy of 21st century. And the 21st century is the century of innovation, is the century of lot of big changes all over the world, is a century of new generation. So our education policy also emphasizes on revisioning of the education system, especially higher education system. It also emphasizes on revamping of higher education system. It emphasizes on multidisciplinary, cross-disciplinary, and interdisciplinary higher education. What I want to say that now we are not going to have educational programs which are very, very specialized, especially at undergraduate level. NEP also emphasizes on quality education. That is the vision stated in the NEP. And through quality education, it promotes accreditation of the institution and of the programs. And after accreditation, it promotes the autonomy. And the accreditation will be in 2-3 stages. Similarly, the degree of freedom, means the autonomy, will also be granted at a higher level. Means more and more degree of freedom will be given to the institutions. Then NEP also talks about multidisciplinary universities or colleges. So now there will not be any stand-alone college, like pharmacy college or engineering college. All institutions will be providing undergraduate programs in all the disciplines, that is arts, science, humanities, management, like that. So by 2040, no college is going to be a specialized college. All colleges need to provide all types of undergraduate programs. So that is why they call it multidisciplinary institutions or colleges. So either there will be autonomous universities, again that will be multidisciplinary, and there could be some institutions which are focused on research activities. So either it will be multidisciplinary education, or it will be research focused education. So this is the vision which is envisaged in the NEP, and only those institutions will survive who will offer quality education, who will be accredited, and who will have autonomy. So in nutshell, that is the vision of the NEP, and NEP also emphasizes on integration of vocational education along with all educational programs, whether it is humanities or science or engineering or pharmacy or management or architecture or like that. So vocationalization will be integral part of the higher education. Similarly, use of blended learning means use of information technology, use of various e-platforms, use of flipped classroom, use of blended learning will again be the integral part of higher education institutions. So this is in nutshell, and this we are going to achieve in next 15 to 20 years. So the vision is very big, resources are limited, and we have to start journey at the early stage. I am very happy that Sagar Group of Institutions is already moving in that direction, has already achieved many milestones, right from school to engineering college to university. So I hope that you will achieve the vision which is envisaged in the NEP, maybe 10 years before, 10 years ahead. So quality speaks on its own. Okay, now coming to students' point of view, there will be multidisciplinary education, especially at undergraduate level. And this multidisciplinary education will also integrate research in the pedagogy. So what I want to say that now there will not be any compartmentalization like civil engineering or mechanical engineering or like that. You will, the students will have to undergo the specific discipline related courses, that is core courses, and the students will have to undergo other courses from other disciplines. So the future educational programs will have multi dimensions. For the industry, for the world of work. So the whole thing is going to be outcome based education. So I have prepared a very small presentation. If you permit, I will take 10 to 15 minutes. And after that, I will open the session for question answer. I am just sharing the screen with all of you. If you're able to see the PPT, please tell me. Are you able to see it?
No, sir.
No. Share screen. Yes. You have already given me the screen. Okay.
Yes, sir, now we can see that.
Okay, fine. I think now you can see it.
Yes, sir. Now it is visible.
Yes, sir.
Great. God is great. God is great. Yeah. So from a student's point of view, we are going to discuss types of graduates. In NEP envisaged that there should be good, thoughtful, well-rounded, and creative individuals. Earlier, we all have been putting lot of efforts, especially in engineering education, on logic. But now we have to develop the logic as well as creativity in our students. And they should be good, thoughtful, and well-rounded, creative individuals. So that would be the focus of all the undergraduate programs. So when the curriculum will be designed, they will take care of all these aspects. Then pursue study in one or more areas of specialization. So suppose I am doing degree in mechanical, I may pursue one or two courses, maybe from the arts or humanities or science or architecture or like that. So one can have two types of specialization or three types of specialization like that. It all depends on the curriculum which is designed by the university. Then possess ethical and constitutional values. Nowadays, it has become very, very important. As we are growing and developing, we are becoming greedy. So just to have control on our greediness, ethical and constitutional values are very, very important. Then intellectual curiosity means whatever you are doing, you are trying to explore the logic behind that. You are anxious to know more and more about that. It means you always ask the question, why? That is intellectual curiosity. Then aesthetic, physical, and emotional, moral, scientific, temper, creativity, and spirit of service. So all these types of skills or competencies or abilities will be developed in the students of 21st century. So all universities will be equipped, all colleges will be equipped with these types of facilities, maybe through infrastructure and equipment, maybe through laboratory, workshop, library, like that, and other facilities to support the sports and cultural aspect. So the institutions and universities need to equip themselves for developing these abilities. In other words, I want to say that there will be faculty members to support these activities, and the faculty members will have expertise in these areas also. Possess soft skills, communication, discussion, and debate. So even the introvert student need to open himself or herself to world of work situation, and he or she should be able to do these types of activities. 21st century capabilities across a range of disciplines, including science, social science, arts, humanities, and language. So one can have a scope and opportunity to pursue the things related to his or her potential or interest or aptitude or like that. Possess professional, technical, and vocational ability. So irrespective of the type of the undergraduate program, everyone has to go through these three types of abilities. So this will be integral part of the curriculum and curriculum implementation process. Quality higher education must enable personal accomplishment and enlightenment, constructive public engagement, and productive contribution to society. So it is not, means it will not only prepare the students to take up the job or to become the entrepreneur, but it sees the pass outs from a bigger and broader perspective. So they should act as a change agent for the society. So from that perspective, and they should contribute to, for the economy of the country. And they should means enrich the culture of the country like that. And they must believe in the constitutional provisions. So the vision of the education is going to be very, very broad in next 10 to 15 years. More meaningful and satisfying lives and work role enable economic independence. So after graduation, the student should become, means should get good job or maybe good business and should become economically independent. I have already told you that the future education is going to be multidisciplinary. So the institutions will redesign their curriculum, incorporating all these aspects, as I told you. Then the curriculum will be flexible. Flexible means multi-entry and multi-exit. Just like IGNU has in our country. They have provided a lot of flexibility for all educational programs for entry level and exit level. And this is how you pursue lifelong learning. So there will be credits for each course. Course means subject. So there will be credit for each course and you can choose the courses according to your interest and according to your need and maybe according to your aptitude. I'm talking about the students. And you can... And you can means opt for that. So institutions, universities, and autonomous colleges need to create curriculum in such a way. So it is not very rigid course, rigid program like 4 years program or 3 years program like that. I enter, I take certificate, I exit. I work in world of work. Then after 3 years, I again join, I take diploma, I again join the world of work. Then after three to four years, I come back, I register for the undergraduate, I do it, and I go in world of work. After that, I pursue my M.Tech like that, or PG program. So the curriculum is going to be highly flexible. And for that purpose, academic bank of credit will be established so that I can earn some credits, maybe from SIRT. And if I'm shifted to Delhi, so I can register in another university and I can pursue higher education or education of my choice there. So there will be an academic bank of credits to the students. And this bank is going to help them throughout their life. Then focus on lifelong learning. Lifelong learning means, as you have seen in my biodata, I have done so many courses. So thanks to my all teachers, who developed or who created interest in me for learning to learn. So I realized that there is a need for learning and I register for that. So that is lifelong learning. Means you don't stop the learning, but as per needs, you go on learning. And in a changing world, there is a need to go on learning. Opportunity for cross-disciplinary and multidisciplinary thinking. So I don't see my discipline from my discipline point of view. What I want to say that my focus is not narrow, but I see the civil engineering problem from maybe chemistry point of view, or maybe from physics point of view, or maybe from electrical or electronics point of view like that, or maybe from social point of view. So I think on a situation from multidisciplinary perspectives. Then student clubs, it talks about the teamwork. And we all know that teamwork produces synergy and creativity. So there will be various types of students clubs, like topic center clubs, sports clubs, cultural clubs, arts and science clubs, eco clubs, activity clubs, community service project clubs, like that. So the students are going to work in a team, means number of teams, so that they will interact with fellow students and at the same time, they will be interacting with many experts and role models, and they will be developing their personality in that way. Research will be integral part of learning, as I have already shared it with you. Assessment of learning will be on discipline-specific outcomes and science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So this formula has been given by promoters of NEP. They call it STEM. And the whole curriculum is going to be outcome based. In most of the institutions, the curriculum is content based, but now the focus will be on development of ability. So when the students graduate, they will be able to perform the ability in real life situation. In other words, it is not like they will work in the industry, they will get experience, and after that they will independently perform. No, the educational institutions will prepare the students with abilities so that maybe after 15 days induction, they will be productively work in the world of work situation or in industrial situation, or they can have their own enterprise. So this is what about students. And to share the behavior of the students, teachers are there, they are the role model, they are the facilitator, they are the architect of teaching learning process. So the role of my colleagues, means fellow professionals, is going to change drastically. In earlier times, teacher used to be only one-way communication provider. But nowadays, means in the context of NEP, they need to become facilitator, guide, mentor, supporter, like that. So the role of teachers is going to change drastically. I am going to talk about that. But before I take up that, if you have any question, I would be happy to respond to that question. So you can unmute in disciplined way and ask the question. Anybody, you are free to ask on NEP.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, I am Anushka Shukla. Sir, am I audible?
Your voice is cracking actually a little bit. Yeah, tell me.
Yes, sir, am I audible now?
Yeah.
Yeah, sir, actually my question is, how it will benefit us? Like as you have said.
Students.
Yes, student means those who have just entered this scenario of learning. As I said, I'll be doing my graduation. So how it will benefit me?
Implementation will take a long time.
So how it? What's the process of implementation?
Social change is a slow process. So definitely it will not have immediate effect. But maybe after 3-4 years, you will see the impact. The students will be benefited for getting the job and for getting the job with a higher package. So there will not be any placement problem, and whatever you will get, it will satisfy you economically. So you will get a job, there will not be job problem. And second thing is you will get the good salary. So this is how it is going to pay the undergraduate students. But not immediately, means not from next year. It will take some time. Social change is a slow process. So it may take 3-4 years of time.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other question?
Good morning, sir. Am I audible?
Good morning.
It's Dr. D.K. Kohli from Mechanical Department.
Sir,
my question is that this national education policy, how will impact on innovation and entrepreneurship? Can you give some light on
it? It will be done through curricular interventions. The curriculum of the university will be designed in such a way so that it will have multidisciplinary approach, cross-disciplinary approach, and interdisciplinary approach. And the entrepreneurship and vocationalization of education will be integral part of curriculum, means the courses will be offered, they will be implemented in that spirit. And by the time the student graduates, he or she will have a business proposal also if they want to become an entrepreneur. So in that way, it is all going to be outcome based. And this is how I think most of the things will be integrated. So it would be my direct answer to your question is through curricular, co-curricular, and extracurricular interventions, it will be done. Any other question?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, myself, Rahul Pawar, I am from Civil Department, SIRD. Sir, I want to know about the challenges which we can face on ground level and what are the necessary steps that we need to take.
Yeah, challenges as a student or as an institute?
Both as an student and as a management faculties.
Yeah. Challenges for institutions are many. Many challenges. Since most of the institutions in our country are running with minimum resources and with many minimum faculty members and with minimum fund. So there are many challenges for the institutions to raise the fund, to employ competent faculty, to create all types of facilities. Many challenges are there for the institutions. If I talk about the students, you have to run. Right now you are walking, but during your course of study, you have to run. And you have to run according to the requirement of the curriculum. So every time you have to make up, patch up, and you have to run. You cannot be so comfortable enjoying student life. Since after undergraduate program, you are going to become professional. So you have to run and you have to run very, very fast. What has happened that our country, everybody is taking admission in the colleges, but their entry level is not good. I want to say they are not trainable like that. So I think they have to make up and then they have to run. So you have to stretch yourself, your capability, your capacity, your self-motivation level. You have to prepare yourself technology savvy. You have to prepare yourself for self-learning. So most of the things are going to be student-centric. Teachers will simply facilitate. So as in a running field, the coach is there just to motivate. Coach cannot run for you. So teachers are going to work as means mentor, guide, counselor, as a coach, facilitator. They are not going to spoon feed everything. So you have to struggle a lot for learning. So everything is means student centric. So the greatest challenge with the student is that first they have to means bring themselves from this level to this level. And after that, they have to run very fast under the guidance of faculty members. Running in the field of learning.
Thank you, sir. It sounds so adventurous. We'll assure you, we will run and we will run fast.
Yeah. And learn on your own.
Do we have any other questions from the participants end?
Yes, sir. I have one question.
Yes, Ashish.
Yeah. Good morning, sir. Myself, Ashish Yadav. I'm the first branch of EC Communication SIIT. Sir, I want to ask about what is the scope of this research sector, research field? When as a student, when you're going in a research field, when I complete my UG and I want to become going to a research sector, what is the scope and what is the challenges by facing this education policy?
During the study or after the study?
Both, during before the study and as a student, we are doing the research as well as researching or as well as studying.
Okay. So during the research, in your curriculum, in every course means subject. So there will be some project, micro project, mini project, sorry, micro project, minor project, major project. So in every course, there will be projects. And most of the projects will be world of work situation based, means industry or field based. And out of those projects, some projects may emphasize on doing research, like modification of a product, or thinking about the alternative material, or saving the energy, or reducing the waste. So it, don't think that it is going to be a very big research, but it will be, you will be following a research process to develop that ability of researching the situation. So through your major projects, minor projects, and mini projects, you are going to develop this ability of researching. So that is one thing. Another thing is Industry 4, you might have heard about it. Complete, what do we call, automation and digitization is going to come in an ecosystem. So there is a lot of demand in all disciplines, whether it is science or engineering. There is a lot of demand for digitization. So definitely, if you have that kind of research aptitude and ability, there will be a lot of scope for for employment, and lot of scope in the employing organization to do research. Actually, most of our educational programs, they don't prepare people for doing research. They prepare students for performing just like worker, but we don't want intelligent or trained worker. Now we want people who can design new things, who can come out with the creative ideas, who can identify the market niche, like that. So definitely, lot of scope is there. When I interview people, generally they say that, sir, I want a job. So we can't simply provide you a job. And they say me that after employment, I will learn. So I'm giving you employment. I'm not giving you education. I'm for production or development, like that. So the institutions will be developing research ready graduates, and there will be a lot of scope in such type of organizations. India is moving towards Industry 4.0. It is a starting point, but yes, we are moving. So a lot of scope is there for students who are having research aptitude and that researching ability.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir. So once again for enlightening us and supporting, and as we know, we are running short of time. I request our convener, IIC, Dr. Dinesh Kohli, sir, to please give vote of thanks.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes, please.
Sir, what policy do university pursue to be a competitive in this information age?
University need to be Industry 4.0, means they need to be digitized. So for every thing which can be done manually, that can be digitized. So most of the things will be available through apps, maybe through software, maybe through institutional website, maybe through learning management system. So whatever routine work and whatever well-designed work we are doing, that will be available in your mobile app. So you can request for everything, means you can give test sitting in Delhi. You can submit the assignment sitting in Singapore, like that. So universities need to be digitized completely. And the teachers will not repeat the things which are available in the textbooks and like that. So it is all going to be activity-based, learner-centric, project-based learning, problem-based learning, like that. So the role of the teacher is going to be changed. in a significant way.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
The universities need to renovate themselves. Means they should also own the digitization.
But sir, there are many problems with online classes.
I understand. But those who will not be doing it, they will die on their own death, I tell you. In next 10-15 years, their existence will vanish, I tell you. Only quality will survive.
Yeah.
But it will take time. And this we have seen in past 5 years. Many engineering colleges and other institutions have been closed down because they never focused on quality.
Like thank that. You, sir.
Ji.
Yes, sir. Sir, I request Kohli sir to please give a vote of thanks. Kohli sir is the convener for the IIC. And under his guidance and leadership only, we are able to achieve the 3-star rating for the present session. I request Kohli sir to please give vote of thanks.
Okay, am I audible, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, on behalf of the head of institute of SIRT, myself, Dr. Dinesh Kumar Kohli, convener IIC SIRT, first, I would like to give hearty thanks to our today's expert, Dr. B.L. Gupta, sir. And firstly, sir has accepted our invitation in a very short time. Sir, we consider that you are very busy, and from your busy schedule, you have given us this time, and you have associated with us for motivating, giving knowledge, inspiring, and sharing this national education policy with our faculty and students, as well as other participants outside the SIRT college or the SAGE group. So we want to say, sir, we are really, sir, we want to say from all of our the IIC team members, our director, sir, and other SIRT members, hearty thanks. Also, sir, you have given some brief points about the national education policy and its impact on the near future. You have shown that up to the 2040, it is a multidisciplinary type. And definitely, sir, this type of culture will build up the future of our students, as well as it will make creative our students, so that it will be research-based, learning-based, practical-based, and definitely it will be helpful for all. Sir, I want to share some things. Last year, we have got the 3-star performance rating from MHRD. Our team is working very actively. Professor Nirjar Gupta, sir, he is also one of the members of our IIC team. And the whole team is working very actively, and so we could get 3-star performance rating in our IIC 2.0, and now we are running in IIC 3.0. We are also running some different programs. We are also moving ahead towards the NIRF as well as area ranking code Dolby for the UGC, and we are trying as being convener towards or with the help of our head of institute, Dr. Manish Manoria, sir, that we could develop an ecosystem of the research, entrepreneurship, IPR, startup in the institute itself. And sir, further, we are also trying to implement the NISP, which is the National Innovation and Startup Policy. So with the help of our team members, we are doing a lot. And at the same time, that just we have got your support also indirectly with the association with us. And sir, you have, sir, very clearly as well as explained to all the students, given the questions, the answer of all the questions, and we are satisfied with that. In the future also, sir, we will make association with you. We will be connected together, and our students are also with you. Our whole the group is also with you. So, sir, first, from our institutes, just as a token of love, so, sir, we are giving this certificate for your today's program.
Thank you.
Please accept it. And I also want to congratulate as well as say thanks to all the members of SIRT, maybe faculty members or the students and the outside members who have joined us. They have made our this short program very successful. So I want to say each and everyone. And lastly, I would like to say thanks for conducting and coordinating this program to coordinator of this program, Professor Nirjal Gupta, sir. He has done a lot of work, takes and several follow-up as well as completed all the processes. So thanks to you all. And if someone has left, I couldn't say the name of his or her. So I am giving thanks to each and everyone. And please continue to be associated with us in such type program, and collectively we will move forward with not only this institute, not only with this group, but with our country as a whole world, as a nation. We collectively will make effort to be successful or to be moved higher and higher. Thanks.
Thank you. May I log out now?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, once
yeah,
again.
Yeah, namaskar. Thank you. See you again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, 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 sir.
Yeah, namaskar. All the best.